All right, let's go over the first situation where we see a fraction. Top over bottom, of course. And as we all know, we cannot divide it by zero. So if this is what you see, then you have to make sure that the bottom cannot be zero. And this is how you are going to set up a condition. So I'll just write this down for you guys. We have to make sure that the bottom cannot be zero. And you have to remember this condition so you can set up an inequality and you'll be able to find the bad numbers for the x, for the inputs in general. Next, we have the square root situation. When you see a square root with an expression inside, well, as we know, we cannot have square root of a negative number, especially when we're just talking about real numbers. Because when you're talking about functions, you also talk about graphs, what the derivative, things like that, especially if you're just in calculus and things like that. So just real numbers. That means when you see a square root situation, you have to make sure that the inside cannot be negative. But can we have zero inside? Yes, square root of zero is zero, so that's legit. But it just cannot be any negative numbers, right? And instead of saying inside cannot be negative, we are going to say, we are going to make sure that the inside has to be greater than or equal to zero. The inside can be zero, but it just cannot be any negative numbers. And by the way, this right here, it doesn't have to be just a square root. As long as you have an even index here, like such as the second root, which is the square root, or maybe the fourth root, or maybe the sixth root, or things like that, you set up the same condition right here. So that's the second situation. And now for the third one, when we have a logarithm situation, log of an expression inside. In this case, we have to make sure that the inside, log of zero, in this case, it's actually not defined. And log of a negative number, it's also a complex number, so it's also not good in our situation. So in this case, we are going to make sure that the inside for the log, the only difference is that the inside cannot be zero anymore. It has to be just positive numbers right here. So we make sure the inside is greater than zero. And the small touch is that I didn't put on any base right here. The truth is, when you have log with any base right here, as long as the base is legit, you do the same thing right here. So here are these three conditions. And as long as you remember these three conditions, you will be setting up inequalities to help you solve for the domain. And now let's look at these examples right here, the first one. So we have r of x is equal to a fraction. And as you can see, this is just the first situation. So all we have to do is pay attention to the denominator. Because in the fraction situation, that's the only dangerous part. And there's no square root, or there's no logarithm, so it's just the first one. All we have to do is we are going to make sure. And I'd really like to write down the term make sure for the domain question, because that helps us to remember what exactly we're trying to do. We're trying to make sure that the denominator, namely x squared plus 3x plus 2, we cannot have 0 in the denominator. So we need to make sure this happens, right? And then from here, you see, we can solve for x. And you do the same thing that as usual. You can just go ahead and factor this out. So I will. Let's go and factor x plus 2 times x plus 1. So we get the factoring for that. And we say this is not equal to 0. And you just solve it. Right here, you say x plus 2 cannot be 0. And the second situation is x plus 1 cannot be 0. And then, of course, right here, you just subtract 2 on both sides. So the first thing that you're saying is that we don't want x to be negative 2. And the second thing is that we are going to say x cannot be negative 1 after you subtract 1 on both sides. So here are the two numbers that we have to prevent to plug in into the x for the function. Because if you plug in negative 2 into this x, of course, into all the x right here, you will end up with a 0 in the denominator. That's going to ruin your function. So that's not good. So as you can see, we are setting up the restriction for this function. And finally, to present your answer, I'm going to use the set builder notation in this video. I will just say the following. domain, I will just put down D for the domain, right? Domain, with the set builder notation, I first open the set, and I go ahead and put down X, and I put down vertical bar. This vertical bar means such that. And the such that just means that here are the conditions. And then, of course, at the end right here, you close the set. So the domain is all the X values, except for the fact that you cannot use negative 2, you cannot use negative 1. So this is how you can present to answer. And that's it, seriously. And of course, if you are dealing with a domain question, you have to remember this definition. And here are the three conditions that you have to remember and the inequality. Otherwise, you wouldn't know what to do with it. And in this case, you don't have to do anything with the top because there's no worry on the top at all. OK, let's go ahead and do the next example. F of x is equal to x squared times e to the x. This question right here for the domain, it's actually really easy. Because as we can see, we don't have any fractions. We don't have any square root. We don't have any logarithm. In another word, we have no worry at all in this case. So this is like heaven. You can plug in any x values that you want. So in this case, the domain, I'll just put on D right here. And depends on how you want to write it. Some people, and including myself, in this case, I will just literally write down all real numbers, meaning that you can use any x values if you like for the function. So that's pretty much it for the domain. And some people, if they want to use the interval notation, they can put down negative infinity up to infinity. Same thing. But I will box this for the answer. And if the answer is all real numbers, you don't really have to put down in a set, in my opinion. You can just write it out. No big deal. Right? So this should be understandable. And then you should definitely check on my next video because I will go over some hard examples with you guys. And then I will be using interval notation in the next video. But anyway, let's move on to this one. 2 plus square root of 5 minus x. You notice that this right here, it's a second situation. So you have to pay attention to the inside. Because we have a square root, so we have to make sure that, that's once again, put down the make sure, the inside, which is 5 minus x. In this situation, we have to make sure the inside is greater than or equal to 0. This is just another way to say, I don't want the inside to be negative. And of course, you put this down so you can solve for this inequality and can present your answer for the domain. Anyway, from here, let's go ahead and move the 5 to the other side. So we get negative x, and this is still greater than or equal to negative 5. And be careful. Next, we divide both sides by negative 1 so that we end up with x on the left-hand side. And the right-hand side, negative 5 divided by negative 1, it's positive 5. But you divide by a negative on both sides, so be sure you switch this to less than or equal to. So be sure you switch the inequality symbol when you divide by a negative on both sides. And I will make a video on why we have to do that, but it's later on. Anyway, this is pretty much a condition. We are saying that we can only use the x values so that x has to be less than or equal to 5. In another word, I can use 5. Or maybe 4.9, or maybe 3, or maybe negative 17. I can use negative 17 because when I use negative 17 here, I had a minus negative 17 becomes positive 17. With the 5, I get positive 22 inside of the square root. So that would be legit. So this right here is pretty much how it works. And of course, that's present our answer. Here is the domain and set builder notation x such that x has to be less than or equal to 5. And this right here is it. All right, last one. This and that are pretty much similar, right? We have the 2, we have the plus. And in this case, we have the natural log. Remember, this is just log base e, the special number e. So this right here, it's the same as the third situation. So in this case, you pay attention to the inside. And you are going to make sure in our situation here, 5 minus x, this time, it's just a greater than 0. This is all we have to do. And then from here, haha, This is so cool because we can solve for this inequality when we finish the question. So let's go ahead and do the usual thing. So finally, the domain for this situation is that it's the set of all the x values, but with a condition, x has to be less than 5. And this right here is it. So hopefully you guys find this video to be helpful. I showed you guys 4 examples, but you know what? I will show you guys more examples before we go, because I just want to make it super clear for you guys. Let's go over example number 5. And example number 5 is going to be right here. So let's see, I'm going to change this to example number 5. And example number 5 is going to be g of x is equal to 2 plus, let's say we have a 6th root right here. 2 plus 6th root of 5 minus x. Suppose this is example number 5. Guess what? It's the same work like what we did earlier. So same thing. Because when you have 6 right here, you're still talking about even root. So this is just like the square root. You still make the inside greater than or equal to 0, and you solve that. So that's it. So that was example number 5. As a bonus, on top of a bonus, let's go over example number 6. All right, 6. I will go to right here again. This is example number 6. This time, instead of putting an even number, let's say we have a cube root, so we put a 3. So let's say g of x is equal to 2 plus cube root of 5 minus x. In this case, what do you guys think what the answer is? It's no longer the same anymore, right? In this case, seriously, it's a really conceptual question, right? So let's just go ahead and erase this right here. Let me just put it back nicely. We still have the 5 like this. Suppose this is the question that we're dealing with. Look at when we have a cube root, it's not the second situation anymore. The truth is, can we have a negative number instead of a cube root, such as negative 8 instead of a cube root? This is totally okay, because the answer is a real number, negative 2. And when we have a cube root function, like this kind of situation, there's no more fraction or log or whatever, if this is just a situation. In fact, we have no worry at all, because we don't have fraction, we don't have even root, we don't have log. This right here, we have no worry at all. So what's the answer? The answer to this, it's the same as that. So let's go ahead and put that down. The domain in this situation is just that we can use all real numbers for the x, and the function is going to work. So this right here will be the domain for example number 6.